this morning and sing praise to Him. This is Pentecost Sunday, and we're going to start with a hymn called Old Time Power. You'll find the words in your bulletin. They were in an upper chamber. They were all in one accord. When the Holy Ghost descended, as was promised by our Lord. Oh, Lord, send the fire just now. Oh, Lord, send the fire just now. Oh, Lord, send the fire just now. And baptize everyone. Yes, it's all. Worship to God. Do we want to leave them standing or sitting? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Laughter is good like medicine. Someone said, you know, it's always good to have laughter. We just want to thank God and we are here today to bless and honor Him. I know. You know, our minds is running here and we're running there, but the only reason we should be here is to glorify God.
Amen.
Because it's all about Him, because we could not even get to what you think you might be going to do, because the rapture could come, or we could leave this world.
So in this moment, as I heard, maximize the moments we have. And let's glorify our God today. Now, on that note, is there any first-time visitors? Any first-time visitors other than... Ooh, you say everybody? Yeah, we do have... Now, listen, we want you to come back now. Praise God. Praise God. God is worthy of all the praise and all the honor and all the glory. And we want to go to him in prayers and thank him and bless him today because he's worthy of all our praise.
Yes.
Of all our praise.
Yes.
Of all our praise. So let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we just thank you today. And we do thank you for another day. And God, we just thank you that we can come before your throne of mercy and grace. And Lord, we can come boldly and we can enter in with praise and thanksgiving to you. Because God, our life should be all about you.
Amen.
To glorify, to magnify, to worship you, my God. To know how much you love us. To thank you for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Hallelujah.
To know, my God, if the trumpet would sound right now, God, that this church would be empty, this building would be empty, God. Lord, because it is about you, Lord, and we bless you today. And Lord, we thank you because we know that you know everything. You are sovereign. You knew this day was going to come.
Yes.
And God, today we just trust you. We trust you because your word said we lean not to our own understanding, but acknowledge you in all our ways and trust you. So today, God, our trust is in you, Father God, as we surrender all to you. And today, let everything, everything that's done and said, every song that's sung, every prayer that's prayed, every word that's preached, glorify you today, my God. To glorify you, Father. And Lord, bless each person here. No matter what they are going through, we know that you are a healer.
Amen.
We know that you are a need meter. We know that you do answer prayers. We know that your ears are open to the cry of the righteous. And God, we know that we can cast all our cares upon you because you care for us.
Yes.
You are our Father. And we just thank you for that. And God, we pray today as your word go forth under the anointing, God, that we will be changed because that's what it's all about. And God, more than anything, we pray that people will come to know you, Jesus, as their Lord and Savior. In this world that we see and hear so much, Lord, that we will be concerned and praying for lost souls to know you, Jesus, as their Lord and Savior. And we bless you today, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen, amen, amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Good morning, good morning. Praise the Lord. I woke up happy today. Thank you, Jesus. I was trying to think of something spectacular that happened to me this week, and it was just a great week. I didn't have anything out of the ordinary, and that in itself is my praise.
Amen.
Thank you, God. He got me through another week and put me right here. I praise God for that. It was just a gentle week. I went to work, came home, had dinner with my husband, got up and did it again the next day. But that in itself is a praise. How God will just order your steps and take you from point A to point B, and before I knew it, it was Friday. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. It was Christ. Thank you, Jesus. I didn't have anything special, but God is everything I've ever needed, everything I've ever wanted. He's the answer to every one of my prayers. So I just thank God for bringing us here one more again to praise Him and to see your beautiful faces. We are going to be reading from the book of Joel and the book of Acts. If you're able to stand for the reading of God's word, thank you, Jesus. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions.
And also upon my servants and upon my handmaidens, in those days will I pour out my spirit.
And when the day of Pentecost was fully come, they were all with one accord in one place.
And suddenly there came a sound from heaven, as of a rushing mighty wind, and it filled all the house where they were sitting.
And there appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire, and it sat upon each of them.
And they were all filled with the Holy Ghost, and began to speak with other tongues, as the Spirit gave them utterance.
God's word for God's people. Be blessed.
Amen. Thank you. You remain standing. We're going to do a little bit of praise and worship.
Where I am weak and frail.
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah. Well, welcome this morning. Miss Ratty gave a great welcome this morning already and a great prayer to begin our service today. Are we glad we're here this morning? Say amen.
Amen.
Amen. I am. I tell you what, today is not only Pentecost Sunday, but we also, and Sister Janice Henson will be introducing our speaker in just a little bit as we have the Eastway Gospel Choir sing shortly. But we're just excited about all the things that are happening. What I want to do first is I want all the council members, where you're at, to stand, please. All of our council, there's 12 of us here in this place. Amen. Amen. They have done a yeoman's job and a yeowoman's job also, if I may say so. I'm going to say this about all of these folks. It's been a pleasure. It is a pleasure to continue to serve with these folks. But again, we have been all on one accord. We're all unanimous, 100% in our thoughts about our candidate who is with us this morning. And Sister Janice will introduce him shortly. We are truly, truly excited about this day that God has brought to Eastway for this season.
Amen.
And I will agree with you, Sister Addie. He can come back again. Amen. In your bulletin, you have several announcements in the air. Eastway graduates. We're aware of one person who is graduating or has graduated. I think last week Olivia did. And she's one of our candidates for graduation, graduates. If you have any others, please write it down on the blue card and turn it in with the offer. We need to know, Anthony's, you got one to show, Anthony? They're around somewhere, or write it on the back of an envelope. There you go, that's the blue card Anthony's got. If you see one of those, or you can write it down on the back of an offering, however you want to write it. And we need their name, where they're graduating from, and telephone number. Yeah. Brother Cherry's got one on the other side there, so he's showing it to.
And they'll be honored on the second Sunday in June.
They're going to be honored on the second Sunday in June. So that will be the 14th, Anthony?
13th.
Thank you, Brother Anthony. And so it's in the bulletin. You can see that, or you can call Sheila in the office. Also, at the bottom of your, where the word for the day was, is online giving. And we've been talking about that now for a number of weeks. So if you'll see that little icon there, that QC code, if you'll use your little cell phone, you can take that and do that. And you can give online without any kind of problem at all. If you have any questions, again, you can call Sheila in the office. Following the message today, we are going to be having a question and answer time here in the sanctuary for our potential candidate. And we'll have two microphones set up down front. We're asking that you will limit your questions to 2 to 3 minutes. And we're going to take about a half an hour or so, I believe, if I'm not mistaken. Is that right, Sister Janice? We said that? About a half an hour for our question and answer session. And so that'll give you all an opportunity. As we leave, our candidate will be out in the vestibule, and you'll be able to shake hands with him as you're leaving. And get it just a quick chance, because there's so many of us here today.
Brother Bill, they'll just speak to him, not shake hands.
No, he said.
Oh, okay.
Yes, sir. No, that's fine.
Double check.
Yes, sir. No, we did double check. Thank you, brother. Yeah. Brother Jim and Brother Anthony were on the same page. But our candidate said, "I'm happy shaking hands."
Okay.
So that's good. Hey, man. Yeah. I can tell you he's a hugger too, but that's all right. He's a man of God right there. And so he'll be out of the vestibule following that. Now, as offering, use your offering envelopes. We'll have our blue bucket out front here on the couch or the chair to the left. Please place your offering. Hopefully, very, very soon, we're going to be passing the offering plates again.
Amen.
Hopefully, we'll be doing communion the right way again, too.
Amen.
So we're looking for those open days to come. So don't forget that, to leave your offering there. And to honor God that way. You know, God says He loves a cheerful giver, and I believe that with all my heart. So today, open your hearts and give as God leads you to give. And I know that He is going to do a great and mighty work in this place today. God bless you, and God bless you, brother, as you bring the word today. Janice will come shortly.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Got a little out of order, so I apologize. We used to follow my mom. So we were all just sitting there like, okay, what next? What next?
Change this one.
Okay, it's all right. Change is good. Change is good. Might not be easy, but it's good sometimes, right?
Amen.
As we get set up, I was driving this morning. I was thinking about what we're singing. I always try to let someone minister to me so we can minister to you all. And the song says, broken but healed. And it says, God can heal, He can deliver, He can mend my brokenness. And I think it's real easy for us to pray for healing. But it's a little bit harder to pray for deliverance and brokenness. Because we often don't want to call it what it is.
Amen.
Because we feel like brokenness and needing deliverance don't look like us. When you think about brokenness, you think about the prostitute on the street or the drug addict, not the person that has it all together.
Amen.
Yeah, you got your house and your car. But you know, there's a lot of broken people that look like they got it together.
That's right.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
There's a lot of people in need of deliverance from
us. Amen.
People, deliverance from people and some things, but they won't call it as such. As we minister today, we always want to sound good. But let this song minister to you, and if you are in need of deliverance, if you are broken, and let me tell you something, I've had some broken days recently. I've had some broken days.
Amen.
Don't focus on what we sound like, but let the song minister to you. It says, God can heal, He can deliver,
amen.
He can mend your brokenness.
Amen. Amen.
Into this building, you bore your burden, you brought your pain, but I have a message for you today. And when you leave here, you won't be the same.
Yes.
Thank you, Lord.
Yes.
So you tell me,
you've
been to your physician. Look at you, there's no change in your condition. Reach out and touch the Master's robe.
Yes.
He's healing for your mind, ooh, your body and soul.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Lord, God can heal. Can you live it, y'all?
He can mend your brokenness.
Yes, He has.
He has a miracle to fit your needs. Once you will trust Him,
you will.
Yeah.
nations, that God is able to heal your needs. He's here to touch you, heal you, let go, and set you free. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Yeah.